Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Brooke-Sidney for those of you that are new to me, and I concentrate on mindset and manifestation to help you reprogram your mind so you can make miracles manifest. Today, I am so excited to share what is the biggest mistake that you're making as you're trying to manifest something, a person, a dream, a house, a car, whatever it is. I'm gonna get into it. But before I do, I want to remind people or welcome those that are new to me to go ahead and subscribe, like this video. I have two ways to work with me. Both are listed below, one-on-one or email coaching, and two communities that are available for free for you to jump into and meet like-minded souls. So let's get into it. What do I see as the biggest mistake people are making right now in manifesting? And I can say that I am seeing this both now in my client calls as well as in my own personal life. The biggest thing that I am seeing is that people are trying to find a band-aid affirmation or a band-aid practice and are not actually doing the mental reprogramming, the mental work, or uncovering what they truly think and believe, right? So I am a coach. I am of the mentality that we can't really band-aid our beliefs. We can't put an affirmation over, like take someone else's affirmation that doesn't ring true to us and place it into our lives without really discovering what it is we truly believe. I think the work is to discover what we truly believe, what is our true dominant state, who we are in the area that we're trying to manifest, and do a little bit of work, at least a little bit of work around how we manifested it. I'm not saying you have to go all the way back and be like, well, you know, back in childhood, this happened to me. You can. It would be helpful because you would see a lot of the programming that you had previously so you can counteract it, rewrite it, revision it, and re-script it. But at the base level, if you're saying, you know, I am chosen, but really you're seeking a relationship that's not just about being chosen, but it's about being committed to and being supported. Can you see how they don't match? So you're going to keep having manifestations because you're going to keep manifesting, right? This is not about whether you're going to manifest or not. We're manifesting every day. We're manifesting constantly. Our current lives, our current 3D is the outpouring or the outpicturing of our minds, our dominant state of being. Everything around us is a manifestation. So make no mistake, you're manifesting. It's just like, are you manifesting what you really want to manifest? And so in order to manifest what we really want to manifest, we have to go back and be clear about what that is. And definitely check out my video from yesterday where I talked all about, you know, really manifesting and how we can manifest things very, very quickly. Go and check out that video. There's two big things to manifest quickly and instantly. And that video really and those teachings speak to what I'm talking about today, in that you have to be clear about what you truly want to manifest it. So we're making a big mistake when we're just picking up affirmations, just rote affirmations that don't really fit. You'll create a new track if you keep doing it. As I've talked before, if you want to learn more about how to create affirmations, check out this video, and then repeating affirmations, check out that one. But the point is that in order to have what you really want, you need to understand the limiting belief that's truly holding you back from what you want. And that's where you revise and re-script and you reprogram. Many of you are programming on things that are not really the problem. They're not the real problem. They're not the real block. So you can manifest something. You can manifest that SP back in because you were trying to manifest a text or manifest a call from the SP. Okay, you got it. But you don't know how to have a relationship, or you still feel unwanted, unchosen, unsupported, unloved, uncommitted to. You haven't worked on those true belief systems, those true dominant states. You're working on a text. Blink, blink. So today, I just want to let you know the biggest mistake that I am seeing with my clients, and I've done it in the past, is not working on the real problem, not creating the affirmation that's truly reprogramming you. It's not to say the affirmation is not going to work. What is the affirmation or the script or the new story that is going to match up and align with your dominant belief system that's keep manifesting the things you don't want? And until you figure out that limiting belief, that dominant state, who you are in that area, who you are with this area and thing you want to manifest, you're going to be unable to manifest your wish fulfilled, your true dream state, because we got to get real about it. We got to uncover what's truly blocking us to really have it fully. You might get parts of it. You might get pieces of it. You might get something that looks close to it. Been there, done that. But to have what we truly, truly want, we need to address what we want and address what's holding us back and create from there. When we do that, when we reprogram, when we affirm, when we feel it as real, we feel it all through our bones and our spirit, we start to believe it and then we start to know it, then we get that manifestation that we truly, truly want and feel like we are living in our wish fulfilled, our dream state and living in the end. So I hope that's helpful. I am excited to see what you're able to accomplish and manifest and create once you get real about the limiting belief, about your dominant state, and you begin to make all of your beautiful, I mean beautiful, wishes fulfilled, and you make your miracles manifest. So make sure you're subscribed, like this video, and I will see you tomorrow.